honor those men and women that protect and serve this great nation, and also those individuals that are adversely affected by war and violence, both here and abroad. We'll follow that with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We're apparently going to separate Mr. Bissell and I.
Just further games, Julie.
We're just... Commissioner Yugovich, we're just trying to split the two of you up a little bit so that we can keep you focused. Okay?
We have a little bit of fun during a meeting.
All right. With that, I will call the St. Louis County Board meeting to order. Turn to Clerk Chapman. Would you please take the roll?
Commissioner Harla.
Here.
Commissioner Boyle. Commissioner Grimm. Commissioner McDonald.
Here.
Commissioner Musa.
Present.
Commissioner Yugovich.
Present.
And Sheriff Commissioner Nelson.
Here. We only have one item on the agenda for today. Obviously, this is a emergency meeting of this county board to deal with the situation that is in front of us in all of northern St. Louis County and parts of southern as well. But so we have one item. It's a resolution declaring a state of local disaster in St. Louis County. It has not been to committee, so I will need to consent to the board to bring this to
I'll make board. A motion to suspend the rules.
Moved by Commissioner Harla, supported by Commissioner Musoff, to suspend the rules to hear this. All those in favor signify by the sign aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The motion is carried. We do have the resolution in front of us. Moved
so
by
moved.
Commissioner McDonald, supported by Commissioner Yugovich. And I will turn to our county administrator. Before I turn to him, I want to tell you that he was working overtime all day yesterday. So if he looks like he's been pushed through a knot hole, it's because I've been pushing him pretty hard. But he is here to give us a heads up on what we're dealing with here today. Kevin.
Thank you, Chair Nelson, commissioners. And you don't need to have a natural disaster in order to push me hard. But we are facing that today. And so I want to thank the board for your availability and to acknowledge that we have two commissioners that couldn't make it. One had a personal conflict, and one had a personal conflict in the form of a new child.
That's
so we're really happy for Commissioner Grimm. But in the meantime, we had a significant rain and storm event on June 18th, and I think the total implications are still unfolding. And as we look ahead to this weekend, we're going to be very vigilant in monitoring the situation as we look ahead to more rain. But more importantly, as the chair talked to me and reached out to the attorney and sheriff as well, we deemed that it's appropriate to send a strong message, a timely message, to support our communities throughout St. Louis County as they deal with this very significant challenge. And I thought today that as we talk about it, I'll briefly state that this action by the board today establishes the opportunity to participate in state and federal disaster relief monies and programs. So that's very important. And my plan and hope is that we would hear from several individuals, including Dewey Johnson from our emergency management lens. And I don't know if Josh is here as well, but I want to hear an update from Sheriff Ramsey and ask him to participate with giving a sense from the field, because oftentimes our 911 and our deputies in the field are the first point of call. And then Jim Faldesi, our Director of Public Works, will talk a little bit about the activity and the fact that we have some real moving targets. So we will continue to update the public on road closures, and they're changing as the water shifts or other situations arise. So the action before the board today is to declare a state of local disaster due to the flood damage of June 18th to public infrastructure throughout the county. And this action will afford, again, the opportunity for the county and public entities and other targeted entities to participate in federal and state disaster relief once, and assuming those thresholds, which I think is a pretty good assumption, will be a reach. So that's the gist of the resolution. And again, we have several individuals here that could talk to it.
Very good. Thank you, Administrator Gray. I'm going to first turn to Sheriff Ramsey because, and then I'll turn to Dewey and Jim in that order. Sheriff Ramsey, please.
Where do you want me to address you from, right here?
Right from the podium, if you would, because that way the mics can pick you up.
Sure. Well, Chair Nelson, Commissioners, it has been a busy few days. Obviously, the significant rainfall has created a number of problems. What has been most impressive to me is how everybody's come together to work, whether it's volunteer fire departments working with us, working together, or citizens helping each other out with wet basements. When I was out the other night when all this was occurring, it was pretty chaotic. To have the support from Public Works, from all of you, from really every community member coming together to make this event go easy, it's been surprising to me. Having been in a leadership role now for 16, 18 years and been through a number of natural disasters, I haven't seen people come together like this, and especially the government entities, whether it's at the state level, the local level, or county level, everybody's working really well together. The only concern I have is I think there still may be some people that haven't got the word out that they need help, so I want to make sure that if there are issues that people contact us so we can get them the help they need. But I appreciate you entertaining this today and everybody on the board's effort to make this go well.
Thank you, Sheriff Ramsey. Any questions from board members of the sheriff at this point? Seeing none, I do want to say, you know how much we count on you and your people. And we've, all we hear is good things, and that we really appreciate those efforts. Okay.
And I would be remiss if I didn't identify our emergency management team. That's
Dewey's coming up here next, because we do have a superhero in Dewey Johnson. Okay.
Yes, and they're on autopilot, by the way. They take care of business. So thank you.
Very good. Mr. Johnson, did I just call you a superhero? Yeah.
Mr. Chair, members of the board, Josh Brinkman has been working nonstop. He's currently up in the city of Cook, meeting with city officials. One thing that this declaration does today is open up the funding, as it's been mentioned. The state threshold for the county is $460,000. That brings state funding, and the state disaster contingency account has been funded by Governor Walz, so there is funding there. The federal threshold is double that. So just under $1 million would be our federal threshold. The state also needs to meet its federal threshold in order to ask the president for federal funding, which is $10.5 million. That's a statewide event. So when I spoke to the state yesterday, they are backdating the start of this event to Monday, when the storms actually started in southern Minnesota. So we have for Monday. This event is still going on, so there's not an ending date. We are still in response mode right now. I talked with Minnesota Power this morning. As we know, the reservoirs are getting full. There probably is a potential for them to start letting water out tomorrow afternoon or Saturday, which is going to bring some potential increased water downstream. So we're still in response mode. City of Cook is obviously devastated. Also, the Wabak area, we have some issues there. Josh is working with both of them. We're trying to get some drones up today up in Wabak to get a bird's eye view of the river. See if we can identify some spots, maybe we can relieve some bottlenecks and get water flowing downstream. The website, county website, will be going active, I believe, today. Dana's working on that. Our IT, we pulled meetings together a couple days. We do have resources available. We need to get, so now what we're doing is called the preliminary damage assessment, getting an idea of what damage is out there. The problem is we can't see it yet. So some of this is going to take time till the water recedes. Is the road still there? Is the road washed out? But the big thing now is to get where is the damage so we can go look and start putting those numbers together. 901's a good number to call. As Sheriff Ramsey says, if you need help, you need to call us and let us know so we can start those wheels going.
Very good. I do know, Dewey, that the governor has talked to several board members myself, Commissioner McDonald, for sure. He did assure me as late as last evening that the state would be there. I tried to explain to him that this is a largely rural area with a lot of small communities without a lot of capacity. So we're going to really need to be on our toes. And he thanked me on behalf of you and Sheriff Ramsey and our public works folks for all we've done so far. So I really feel the support of the state on this, as well as our legislators. We've got one here, and Senator Hochschild has been on the phone with me several times as well. So we're really seeing and feeling the support of our state and federal folks. Also talked with Congressman Stauber and Senator Klobuchar as well. So
one thing to clarify too, I've been getting questions from the cities if they need to declare a state of disaster also. They do not, unless it's in their local protocols. Right. The county declaration does cover all the cities and townships within St. Louis County.
So they'll be able to piggyback on our correct declaration?
Yes, that covers everybody, yes, within St. Louis County.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Questions of Dewey at this point? Thank you for what you do, okay? I will tell you, this is the third time, well, I've chaired more than three times, but this is the third time in a row that when I've been chairing, we've had a natural disaster, okay? And I don't know if I'm a jinx or what's going on, but it's hard to imagine that this is to the day. It's 12 years to the day from the 2012 flood to the day.
Yep.
And then the windstorm 6 years ago. So we're having these types of things that are hitting us, and we're seeing the importance of your group as well as all of the people in St. Louis County coming together.
And we're learning. We're learning from past disasters. I was mentioned the other day, you know, we were quick to pull the county leadership crew together. You know, yesterday was a holiday. We were all working yesterday. But we have things in place. We have sandbags, Springfield, and locations we've been before. We have 100, you know, almost 150,000 sandbags in stock, which, you know, 6, 7, 8 years ago, we didn't flood as often, but we're in a lot better place. I think we're better poised. Things come together quicker, having the resources, you know, such as the technology of drones, the GIS, having the maps available to the public, showing the road closures and public works, you know, getting up to speed right now. We're in a lot better place to respond, and I think we're doing what we can, and so far, things are going very, very well. So
I don't want to practice anymore, but
unfortunately, we've had the practice.
We've had some experience. Are we seeing a couple of years ago when they had the flood issue up in Coochin County? We worked a lot, and that was up on the northern edge of Commissioner McDonald's district as well.
Yep.
We had a lot of resorts that had a lot of issues. Is that something we're hearing already?
We have not had any reports yet. We've had the one resort was the end of Mud Creek Road on the north side of Lake Vermilion. The volunteer rescue squad went out yesterday and went door to door and made notifications to all of those people and the resort at the end of the road. And they were all aware, they're all good. But our volunteer rescue squad has also stepped up to the plate, helping along with Josh Brickman coordinating that. But yeah, that's the only resort that I've heard. And that wasn't really flooding issues, but they are cut off due to the washout, which I'm sure Jim will talk about.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Questions, concerns for Dewey at this point? Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay. Director Faldesi, again, we don't need to practice this anymore, but we're throwing your whole crew a curveball too, so let's hear what we got going on. I saw the closure list, and that's still in flux, is it? Or?
Yes.
Okay. So,
thank you, Chair, Commissioner Nelson, commissioners. We are getting very well versed at this, unfortunately. And I apologize, this is my get work done attire, not my usual coat and tie.
That's why we're here.
I'm gonna kind of back up and give a little status report or history of the response so far, and then kind of move into what we are planning to do moving into the future. So essentially yesterday it was identifying all the sites, getting the signs, appropriate signage up at all of the locations where road closures needed to happen because of either water over the road or damage that we didn't want people driving through. And so, yesterday was essentially that first emergency response of getting everything signed appropriately so that we don't have additional situations where people are either driving into water or, you know, having some other type of accident that law enforcement then needs to respond to and kind of putting strain on those resources. So that process was yesterday. It's kind of a dual response of getting signage out there, but then of course we're also identifying damage sites at the same time. And yesterday we did get into some repairs. Typically we focus on the dead end situations where people can't get out other than getting that repair done. So typically that's where we focus our forces first. And again, our as Sheriff Ramsey stated, our folks are kind of also on autopilot. They know what to do in these situations. They're doing it, they're doing a fantastic job. They know how to prioritize appropriately and get work done in a quick manner. We also have to keep in mind as we're doing those repairs, documentation, because ultimately we're gonna be looking for reimbursement. So that whole process needs to concurrently take place. So you're rushing in to fix this stuff, but you also need to document it really well so that that reimbursement comes later. We make decisions about, are these temporary repairs or are these permanent repairs as we do them? That's something else that is kind of going on in the background. So we're transitioning, you know, today more to a repair process. It is a little bit of a whack-a-mole situation right now. This is dynamic, so water goes down over here. That all is traveling downstream through these river systems. And so over here, now we've got a spot where we've got to put up barricades and block the road off. So this is a dynamic situation. Chad Skelton will be basically taking reports from our superintendents of road openings and road closures, updating in a dynamic fashion our map online. So we're trying to keep that up to date and similar to what we did in 2012. Big picture wise, you know, kind of 2012 is our standard for mega disaster. The last few years we've had smaller disaster response. I would say this is kind of in between that at this point, you know, as far as scale and cost. Going to this weekend, if we, you know, everything is full out there, and if we get another 2 or 3 inches of rain, that is going to escalate that this situation. The other thing that's starting today and into tomorrow is we're engaging our engineering staff to go out and essentially help maintenance from the standpoint of collecting data on all the current damage locations, doing estimates, and basically coming up with a number that ultimately will be reported through DOE to help start building those cost numbers for federal and state thresholds. So, and every other organization out there, township, city, will need to be doing that same thing of doing cost estimates and ultimately turning those into to St. Louis County so that we can determine what level of event this is.
So as we take our first steps, we're looking for those local entities to follow in those footsteps and try and help us fill some of those.
And so for St. Louis County's infrastructure, we're doing that, of course, all in-house. But as townships and cities look at their infrastructure, they need to be putting together those numbers. And Dewey and staff will be reaching out in an email blast, you know, basically requesting that information.
And the big difference between this and 2012, I mean, this one is hitting largely rural areas. And that's where I think some of my rural commissioners are and myself are very concerned that the resources just aren't there. Okay, so thank you for
Commissioner Nelson and board members. Yeah, I mean, if you're kind of looking at St. Louis County right now, if you draw a line from kind of like the Side Lake area across the county and north, that's where the majority of the damage has occurred. There, you know, there is damage, you know, Hibbing and Chisholm South. There's some damage in what we call our 6th District of Virginia area. Very little. There's a few locations in southern St. Louis County, but they're pretty scattered and few. So yeah, the focus really is on the northern third of the county at this point in time. Again, you know, let's pray that we don't get a lot of rain this weekend, because depending on where that happens, you know, the entire county is still, I would say, at risk at this point in time.
Very good. Thank you. Questions, concerns? Commissioner Yugovich.
No concern, no question, but I just want to tell you how wonderful staff has been. Everybody in Public Works, everybody top to bottom, every position, you name it, St. Louis County has really done well coming together. This morning, 4:45, Commissioner McDonald and I were texting with Joe Hannigman because I said, keep me appraised of the situation. 4:45, the text started rolling in. Chad Walters calling, letting me know what's going on, letting me know what they're doing to move forward, to take care of our residents. So really, it comes down to leadership, and we appreciate the people that are there getting these things done. But when I wanted to be appraised of it, there was no question. At 4:45, this just happened. So we are very, very fortunate. So
thank
we
you.
Appreciate everybody in the entire county coming together to take care of our citizens.
Thank you.
Thank you for that, Commissioner Yugovich. Any other comments or questions of Director Faldesi at this point? Sorry, I didn't hang the superhero label on YouTube, but
that's okay.
We can only have one in the room, and Dewey's the one, okay? So, Administrator Gray, I didn't hang the superhero label on you either, so.
And you'd have great, you'd have a 7-0 vote on that, not any. Commissioners, again, thank you. We have a number of individuals here. There may be some people that want to comment to the resolution as well. But I do want to say that it's not routine, but we're trying to be better at being proactive and responsive, and we learn. And we try to apply those learnings, and I think we're seeing some of the benefits of that. That does not take away from the impacts to our businesses, our residents, the personal stories that we see, that some of which are heartbreaking, some of which are heartwarming. And I just know that this board has asked me consistently, are our residents safe? What can we do? And that was a big impetus for having this emergency meeting, as just so we send a strong signal to our communities and to our citizens that we're going to work hard to do what we can, at least on the public infrastructure side. And we'll look at other options and how we can help, but largely this declaration will afford support for our communities, our cities, our townships, and of course we'll be addressing this for our UTs, the unorganized townships. So never think that we're losing sight, though, of the people that we're serving, and this board has reminded me that virtually on every call, and I think we're sharing that, as opposed to it's not really a reminder, because you know, and you can tell by the staff commitment starting Tuesday night, spent several hours with Director Faldesi, and people were out into the early morning hours and back at 5, 6 a.m. on the day after the event. So a lot going on. And I will tell you, too, that I'm tremendously impressed with the responsiveness of our cities and communities. When you see the local fire departments and the volunteers out there, city officials who are reaching out to me, some of whom are here today, others that have contacted individual commissioners, I just want you to, we can't change the rainfall. We can maybe do some temporary and maybe some permanent repairs that are better. And I think there's going to be some challenges that we address at every entity level in that regard. But we're doing as well, I think, as can be expected. And I do want to finally, somewhat selfishly, thank our team. You've got a number of St. Louis County staff from multiple departments. When we met yesterday on a couple hours notice, and we probably had 15 to 16 different individuals there, everything from public health and supportive services. The attorney's office has been engaged, and Attorney Mackey and her team have helped us every step of the way to ensure that we're crossing the right T's and the right I's legally as well as substantively. The sheriff's office, his whole entire team, including the 911 group, you can't say enough about them. A little known fact, but as we look for more information, we had at least two members of our GIS, our technology team, on board supporting the emergency management response. So, and of course, the public works response and our team is incredible. So Jim has already mentioned that they're working on both the bringing our, we have some of our engineers here, bringing that expertise and freeing up some time for our maintenance folks to be responsive to critical safety and repair activities. So it's been a journey, and it's not over, as Jim said, but it has been a lot of communication, and Josh Brinkman has been everywhere. I talked to Sheriff Ramsey, I talked to Dewey, and Josh is here, Josh is there. Our team is really trying to reach out, and I hope and trust that this declaration will afford everybody, as you intended when you talked to me about, can we move this forward a little bit? And there's agreement, as I checked in with other commissioners, just send that signal to our communities again. And I think that's important. So thanks for letting me have a chance to pontificate a little bit, but a little bit of pride here. And we still have a daunting challenge, and we're going to work hard at it to support and ensure the safety of our citizens, businesses, and visitors.
Very good. Is there anyone here that cares to address the county board at this point? Mayor Cuffey. I have to ask you to introduce yourself for the record, sir. I'm sorry.
Thank you. Larry Cuffey, the mayor of Virginia. I'm just here just briefly to say thank you for putting this order together. It's very important you take a leadership role on making sure that it's accomplished. So, Board Chair and Commissioners, thank you for that. But this morning at 7:30, the City of Virginia had an emergency City Council meeting, in which under the 1229 statute for the state of Minnesota, we declared it a local emergency with respect to this. And after conversation with you, Councilor, Commissioner Nelson, we set up a website, and we set up on our Facebook page to do exactly what you've asked everybody to do. Get an assessment of the damage, where it's at, what our costs are associated with that. And so after talking with you and with Governor Walz and with Ida Rukavina from the IRRRB and from Congressman Stauber and others, I just want to say thanks for doing this, and we'll be looking forward to working with you very closely to help alleviate the angst and the damage and help these citizens whole once again. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Cuffey. Is there anyone else who cares to address the county board? Please come forward if you would.
I'm a landowner.
Okay, could you please come forward, sir, if you can?
I'm right there.
Please.
I would have dressed a little differently if I knew I was coming.
You're fine. You're fine. We are here to work. Okay. Please state your name for the record.
Clark Corky Hayden. I've been in Boabas for 80 plus years. The reason I'm here is this recent washout affects my own personal property. I own a property on Embarrass Lake there, right where the river comes out. And this is really a big deal. It's going to be very timely and expensive to get fixed. And my suggestion to whoever the engineers or whoever I talked to Commissioner McDonald about this already this morning, I surveyed that area last night on my side-by-side. I got to admit, I went around the closed gates because I wanted to see what the heck's going on. The series, I own 260 acres adjoining and a part of the very property that flooded. So I'm pretty aware of the contour and the layout of the whole land. I've been a landowner for about 10 years, and I still own 7 acres of this. So I think it was Tuesday, I was looking out at our lake. I live right there on the lake. I was looking out there, and all of a sudden, I see the water looks brown. I said to my wife, I said, I hope this ain't happening again. I have a picture on my phone I can show you. And all of a sudden, the water is brown. So I called a friend of mine that lives downstream, and Bert says, I hope this ain't happening again. Why the hell are we getting this brown water coming through? Well, I was at 5:03 on my phone. That's when all hell broke loose up there. So then my travel yesterday, I find out on what property I used to own, there's a series of four beaver dams. First of all, the northernmost beaver dam is gone, washed out. Looked on a little further, the next beaver dam is washed out. Look a little further, the next beaver dam is washed out. Now, if you aren't really familiar with this property, you cannot see what's called the Hector mine pit. These beaver dams, that water runs into the Hector mine pit. The Hector mine pit is where the water discharged to the first washout here 6 years, 7 years ago. Now, that Hector mine pit collapsed, and that caused this second, or the washout yesterday, or whatever day it was. So that was a cause of that, a series of beaver dams. So my suggestion to Paul this morning is what you people should do is, everybody got, not everybody, but there's drones with pictures. Take pictures of the landscape of that property and see where all these dams in the former mine pits are and where that water can possibly go before you spend a ton of money engineering. Let's find out where all this water is coming and going to. So the series of dams is a big contributing factor there. But then up the trail going towards Giants Ridge, and I'm talking about a hiking, biking trail that runs parallel to what we call the channel. That river, most people here probably don't know that. That river is not a natural river. That river is man-made. It was dug, called a channel, by the local people, and it was dug there to divert the Embarrass River. The Embarrass River used to run right through Lake Mine and where the quarry is now, and it came into Embarrass Lake on the end. That channel was man-made and dug there, and then the water was supposed to be rerouted. Thank God they didn't do that, because it would be a disaster. So anyhow, now that channel, we call it, has a concrete dam close to the main highway. That concrete dam, that's going to be jeopardized next. Somebody's got to look at that. If that goes, pardon my expression, all the shit from the whole river is going all the way downstream, all the way through the chain of lakes. Embarrass River forms a series of seven lakes, starting from Wine and Sabin, and the last lake is Esquagam. All that dirty water, I used to have a nice beach. That's all going downstream. And now, instead of a nice beach, I had one of the nicest sand beaches on the lake. Now, when that sewage pipe broke on the last one, now my beach is sewage. And I've never complained to anybody about it or anything. What am I going to do about it? But now it's happening again, and if this isn't fixed correctly this time, it's going to keep happening. So my point of view is to really analyze what the hell's going on here. And aerial views of it shows, where's these dams that Corky's talking about? Where's these beaver ponds? Where is this Hector mine pit and Ajax mine pit, and how's that affecting the water going into that channel? So anyhow, I got to thank Commissioner McDonald and Keith Nelson. When I've needed your help, you guys have been there for me.
So thank you for coming today, and certainly, as you heard our engineer talk about solutions, we're looking both short and long term. Thank you very much.
Well, studying it with photographs is a good start.
Right. Very good.
I have another issue, but it probably better not bring it up.
Appreciate it. Is there anyone else who cares to address this board at this time? All right. Seeing none, I'm going to turn to fellow commissioners. Anything to say on this, in regard to this? Both directions, Commissioner Harlow.
I just want to thank you, Chair Nelson, for your leadership on this and making sure that this was called today. You don't often ask for that thank you, and so just want to thank you. I know you, when we spoke yesterday, you had heard from a lot of local folks, but even before they were asking, you were pushing to make sure this happened. So we appreciate your leadership, and I'm learning a lot from you in this process. So thank you.
Thank you. I've had practice, as I told you, but we don't need any more practice. When I drove to Cook yesterday, and I drove up there on a planning issue, I almost couldn't believe what I saw. And it was shortly after that Administrator Gray and I talked and was looking for how do we do this. But I wanted to make sure that I involved all of my fellow commissioners in this process. And that's why we came to the resolve of calling a special meeting. So with that.
Thank you, Musa. Thank you, Chair Nelson. You know, and you're absolutely right. But you know, we heard from Sheriff Ramsey, Director Johnson, and Director Fildesi. I thank you three for the hard work you've put into, but please take back to your departments and staff the true, genuine thank you to the folks at the boots on the ground. Without them, we would be nowhere for our communities and our residents. So please share that message back. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner Mussoff. Commissioner McDonald, please.
Yes, I'm going to save most of my remarks for the press briefing, but again, it's been a whirlwind the last few days. As Commissioner Jugovic stated, you know, starting at 4:45 this morning, yesterday was, they gave us a little break. I think it was 5:20 before the phone call started. But it's been very enlightening. And as Sheriff Ramsey in a private conversation we had earlier said, it's amazing, you know, how people are able to come together in times of trouble. And we've seen that throughout the county. And people have been patient and understand that everything's not going to get fixed immediately, but to make us aware of it and make our staff aware of it, I think goes a long way. So if something does pop up, as Director Fildesi said, if we happen to get more rain, please reach out to 911 and let us know so we can be aware of that and proper signage is posted if need be, et cetera. But again, to echo what Commissioner Mussoff said, we have an amazing team at St. Louis County. And what they've done in the last 2 days is, you know, top notch. As a coach for so many years, I would be proud to be a coach of a team like we have assembled. And Dewey and Josh and Jim and Brian and the rest of them, along with, you know, the sheriff's department, et cetera. It's amazing how everything comes together. And I've had many conversations with cities and townships as we navigate forward. But I trust Commissioner Nelson in putting this together and look forward to remedying as much as we possibly can in the shortest amount of time we can. But citizens, rest assured, we're there for you, and hopefully, as Director Fildesi said, the rain stays away from us this weekend. That's all I have, Mr.
Very good. Thank you, Commissioner McDonald. With that, and we have the resolution in front of us, let's help everybody get to work by passing this resolution. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Same sign. Motion is carried unanimously. And the next motion I need before we start the press conference portion of this, which thank you all for being patient with us, is a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Commissioner Harla, supported by Commissioner Jugovic. All those in favor of adjourning the special meeting of the St. Louis County Board, signify by the sign aye.
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 Opposed? Same sign. Motion is carried.
2 minutes to we're still to retool and set this up, and so I think we could almost stay right here.
Okay, well, the board meeting is over, but